takes on Son Wan Ho. And as you can see, for Lin Dan and Son Wan Ho, we have to say, rather more comfortable, wasn't it, in the quarterfinals for Son yesterday than it was for Lin Dan. Given a bit of a fright by Sho Sasaki. Yuan Jorgensen coming through comfortably against Tian Haowei. Chao Tian Chen taking three games to see off Unka Long Angus. That's on the fifth final match for you on our coverage here, the Jorgensen Chao semi final. It's always a big deal wherever he is when Lin Dan's in town. Of course, over the last decade, along with Lee Chong Wei, it's been a brilliant battle between the two. And of course, Lin Dan is the one that's risen to the top on so many occasions, as he has done here in his visits to Germany as well. Two times Olympic champion, five times world champion, five times All England champion, and let's not forget, five-time German Open champion as well, Lin Dan. Can he make it six here? Can he make it six at the All England? Son Wan Ho is the man he takes on. Just awaiting for the arrival of the officials and the players. Going to be very good semi-finals, particularly, this could be, depending on how Son Wan Ho takes it on, but in head-to-head, Lin Dan has been dominant. You feel the final match we'll see here this afternoon. The match between Jorgensen and Chao, that could be a real thriller, a really tight match. And of course, still got that women's doubles match to come as well. Maheswari and Polly taking on Putita and Sasbury. Gives me a chance to let you know how the other results have gone on the other court as well, while we await what's happening here. Shinbei Cho and Chai Yu Jung have booked their place in the mixed doubles final. It's a case of who they'll take on. It's going to be an all-Korean final, and it's a very close match that's going on between Ko Shin Hun, Kim Hao Na, and Seok Yu Choi and Om Hye Won. Ko Shin Hun and Kim Hana, the number one seeds, look as if they're going to edge that one. It's in the third game, 19-16 to Ko and Kim in that third game. Here come the officials. Here comes Son Wan Ho. And down following him out. Well, he knows the task ahead of him. He's played Lin Dan on a number of occasions as Son Wan Ho. Looking for his first win since the Hong Kong Open in 2014. Lin Dan's last victory back in September at the Japan Open. But for Lin Dan, of course, he wants to win this week. He's come here to win. Same next week in Birmingham, but it's all about trying to become a triple gold medal winner. So Sun Wan Ho, the number 8 seed, ranked 13th in the world. Just over a year ago, he did get to number 4 in the world, now 13. Not been a great start to him for 2016, lost in the second round of the Syed Modi International in India, the first round of the Malaysia Masters, another the Grand Prix Gold event, made the quarterfinals at the Thailand Masters last time out. And you have to say it was a disappointing 2015 really for him, after finishing 2014 on a high when he won the Hong Kong Open. As you can see, been very straightforward for him. Ashok Paripalli looks as if he picked up another injury, but Sun was on top anyway in that one. And then a very convincing display against Wei Nan in yesterday's quarter final. It's time to tell you Ko and Kim did win that semi-final in the mixed doubles. Well, what is there to say about Lin Dan that you don't already know? World number 5, number 2 seed here this week, looking for the ultimate final goal of his career, a third Olympic gold medal. In his 2016 campaign, more than likely his very last year playing in these international tournaments for Lin Dan. Well, what will it produce, I wonder? He's shown a little bit of fallibility there yesterday. In straight games wins until he ran into Sho Sasaki. Was 11-7 up at the interval, but lost that second game 22-20. And then he was 8-3 down in the third as well. As you can see, came through 21-17 in the end. Took an hour and 12 minutes. But probably the kind of game he'll say that he will benefit from. Well, there's the head-to-head, and well, it's very dominant, isn't it, from Lin Dan. Although Son, as you can see, won their last encounter. That was in September at the Korea Open, 21-10, 21-15 as well. Very convincing. They'd also met earlier that month at the Japan Open. Lin Dan won that in 3 games before last year, all straight great games wins for the Olympic champion. So some hope for Sun Wan Ho. Here's Michelle Gutis, our umpire.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Lin Dan, China. And on my left, So Wan Ho, Korea. So Wan Ho to serve. Level. Play.
So, Lin Dan, in Olympic year, can he get off to a winning start in 2016? Looking to book himself a place in the German Open final, a tournament he's won on 5 occasions in the past. Sun Wan Ho hit, standing in his way of that. And it's Lin Dan who takes the opening point.
Service over. One love.
His last event before coming here was at the Olympic venue at the Brazil Open. Lin Dan, pretty vocal about what he thought of it. Wasn't too impressed by the sounds of it. He hits that one long. Did win the tournament, though. Before that, showing signs maybe he wasn't any longer the invincible player that of course, we've come to know and love. Lost in the second round in Hong Kong, beaten in the semi-finals of the China Open, lost in the first round in the French Open. No victory either in Denmark or at the Korean Open, where he made the last 16. And of course, quarterfinal loss to Jan Jorgensen, who could be his opponent tomorrow in the final, should both players get there. But that's beautifully placed from Sun Wan Ho.
2-1.
Lost to Jan Jorgensen at the World Championships. And well, yesterday, some worrying moments for him. Came through in the end against Sho Sasaki. Confident start by Son. Wide this time from Lin Dan.
4-1.
Some good shots from Sun Wan Ho, but it has been a few errors in there as well from Lin Dan. Needs a new racket as well. String obviously went in that one. Not the start he was looking for. I have to say, it's a perfect start for the Korean. He was the number one singles player in the Thomas Cup qualifiers for Korea last month. Only won one of his three matches. Umpire having a word with Lin Dan. Didn't seem too enamored by it. Happy to let that one drop long.
Service over, 2-5.
Ooh, just out.
3-5.
Well, new racket maybe is bringing a bit of a change of fortune.
5.
He's won four straight points since he's changed that racket. Winner of the German Open in 2004, 2005, 2007, 2011 and 2012. Of course, the latter being the Olympic year. And you know, that wonderful final with Lee Chong Wei. All those in Mülheim, which is where we are now, Mülheim and then Ruhr. Five straight points now for Lin. It's been the venue since 2005 for a tournament that started back in the 1950s, the German Open. And I tell you, the crowds really have flocked here. It was a sellout, the semi-finals, over a week ago. Another ticket to be bought, and the crowds were here. We're about 2 hours before the first match got underway. It was packed in here.
Oh. 7-5.
Well, rather, let's put it, erratic start. It's been firmly put to bed by Lin Dan. Oh, and you can see some Wan Ho
eight
looking to get there. He did get there, but just mistimed it. Worrying times for him. He got off to such a good start as well.
Nine, five.
10, 5. Well, any Lin Dan fans watching would have thought at the start of this match, well, this is a bit concerning. Nine straight points, and you're all relaxed again, aren't you? Oh, just wide.
Service over.
Oh, that grateful point taken from the Korean.
Service over. 11-6 interval.
Well, it was pretty emphatic in the end. The response, he 5-1 up, some Wan Ho, seemingly after a cruising start. But Lin Dan has put the heat on him since then. Man, it's 11-6. Good lead for the two-time Olympic champion at the interval.
Court one, 20 seconds. Thank you, coach.
Well, he's won it all, hasn't he? Olympic 11, world, as he had Thomas Cups, Sudirman Cups. Oh. Each major, of course, marked by a star tattooed on his left arm. Is there room for another couple this year?
Over
50 individual titles.
7-11.
Oh, ooh, given out.
8-11.
Got to say, I thought he was in. Lin Dan certainly thought he was in. Obviously, the nine judges have made some very good decisions for much of the day so far. 8-1. He won't care. And I don't think he'll be too bothered, really. Unless, of course, things suddenly start turning against him. Long from Son.
Service over. 12-8.
Yeah, easily out. No. You're not sure what's coming back at you, so I'm waiting for the power, but it was more
13,
more craft
eight.
To it than that, wasn't there, from Lin Dan? A little bit more finesse than maybe what was expected. If they're very short, always going to be punished. Longest rally of the match, and it ends there. Well, 14 out of 17 points for Lin Dan. Don't need to tell you much more than that. We'll be pleased, no doubt about it. You know, there's a balance here between this being a warm-up event for bigger things to come, namely next week, of course, in Birmingham at the All England Championship, where obviously everyone will be. Of course,
14,
we had a surprise exit very early on this week when Victor Axelsen went out. But, of course, the dream final, I suppose, for the neutrals tomorrow would be Lin Dan taking on Jan Jorgensen. Lin Dan going some way so far to try and make sure he's there. Looking very comfortable right now, isn't he?
15-8. Service over, 9-15.
Well, the points are few and far between for Sun Wan Ho.
Service over, 16-9. Service over, 10-17.
Well, a rare error, but he certainly can afford them right now, Lin Dan. fairly emphatic from him, really, this opening game. Happy to leave that one.
Service over. 18-10.
All his training, all his preparation at the moment is really about building up to Rio, making sure he's at the peak of his powers there. Well, he looks pretty strong and fit so far here, doesn't he?
Service over, 11-18.
Well, I suppose we've got to enjoy it while we can. We certainly enjoy what's been a wonderful career, the most decorated player in badminton, last few months potentially of it. A few of the players might be happy to see the back of him though. Nine meetings, I should say, for someone who's anyone one of them. That was the last one, and he gets himself another point there as Lin Dan goes just wide 80. Here in the RVA Sport Halle in Munheim.
Service over, 19-12.
So game points.
20 game points.
You can't say it's... been an exciting semi-final so far. Just the way you would want it, really. He had enough excitement, I suppose, yesterday against Sho Sasaki. And too many mistakes and too much power for Lin Dan. Too many mistakes from his opponent. And that's very comfortable.
21-12.
Just the 21 minutes, 21-12. The scoreline, Lin Dan with 1 foot in the final of the German Open. Well, they got some working out today, otherwise this could be all over in a flash.
Court 1, 20 seconds.
Well, Lin Dan.
Court 1, 20 seconds.
Ready to go already. As you'd expect, he in a hurry maybe to put his feet up and get himself ready for a final. I mean, you never know in sport. That's why we love it so much. But there is a sense of inevitability about this one.
Lovell. Play.
My. Wow. Got to remember, though, he did start the opening game pretty well, didn't he? Injection of speed in that Semi shot from Lin Dan.
One all. Semi-server, 2-1.
Just wide from Son this time.
And Semi-server, 2-all.
Back to 2-all in this second game. Lin Dan obviously in control after taking that opening game.
Semi-server, 3-all.
Gave that one the eyes there, the Olympic champion.
Semi-server, 4-3.
No play.
Semi-server, 4-all.
To Wang Gai-chong and Tang Jinhua have made it through in the first game in their women's doubles semi-final against Matsutomo and Takahashi. A set up.
Service over 5-4. Thank you. Five, four. Six, four.
Must be time for some Wan Ho here. He's played Lin Dan 9 times before. Yes, he did win the last time they met. But he must feel what we feel here, which is, what's the winning scoreline going to be? How many points can he win rather than can he win the match? Obviously, he doesn't want to be defeatist. You've got to believe to obviously beat the best.
Service over.
But he hasn't found it easy to make inroads into the Lin Dan defence. Most of his points recently have come from some errors from the Chinese player.
Service over 8-5. Father, 6-8.
Yeah, that was good.
9-6.
Well, I would say he's hardly broken a sweat, but it's quite clear he is sweating. But yesterday, it was a little different for Lin Dan against Shea Sasaki, remember? He was in a similar position to this, really, and ended up letting that second game slip. You don't think he's going to fall for that one again.
10-6.
Just those two wins for him last year, Asian Badminton Championships and that event in Brazil. Well, he's always been an athletic person, flinging himself at that one on the slide. And then sees that the shuttle's gone the wrong side of the court.
Come, please.
Like a footballer on a wet turf there, wasn't he, making a sliding tackle? He's even the best at mopping, isn't he? It's sweet they've got these young girls here doing the mopping. Often is down to the line judges, but he did slide a lot there. There was a lot to mop up. That was a nice moment.
Service over. 11-7.
But that gives you an idea of the intensity of this match. In other words, there isn't really that much intensity to this match. You can hear the crowd. They're into it, but they're not that into it. Scored by the way. Needs another point for Lin Dan. He's 11-7 up at this second interval. not one of those to enthrall the neutral. Lin Dan, very efficient here.
Court one, 20 seconds. Court one, 20 seconds. Seven, seven. Play. Court. Twelve, seven. Service over, 8-12.
Yeah. Now that looked disappointing some more than anything, 13, really. That was just
eight.
Basic mistake. Needless one. Those unforced errors really hurt. Thing is, Lin Dan doesn't even look in top gear, does he? He sometimes makes it look that way.
14-8.
I get a better idea of where he's at in tomorrow's final. Should he be there? Or is that that just in case? It's a better rally. Now they're frustrating me. He played some really good shots off the ground there. Suggesting he was maybe stirred by the
14.
Lighting. Yeah, just wide of the mark. It's a big lead now.
15-9.
Yeah, fabulous. Nothing's going to stop him today.
Nine. Seven. Service over, 10-16.
Well, a disappointing match in some ways. Certainly seen some skills from Lin Dan. You want to see a contest, don't you? I'm afraid there really hasn't been much of one. That's given in.
11-18.
Apology from Wan Ho.
18.
Don't know why, it was a good shot. Short. That's really nicely played. And that's what the best do, isn't it? In any sport, they make things look easy. See those stars from Lin Dan's arm there. Still 2 points away from victory for Lin Dan.
13-19.
So match points have arrived.
Service over.
It was a question of when and not if, wasn't it, in this match?
20, match point, 13. Game.
Finishes it in style. Lin Dan, well, I don't think he needed to be at his very best today, but he looked very good indeed, didn't he? Never in doubt. After going 5-1 down in that opening game, it was just one-way traffic after that from the two-time Olympic champion. Yesterday, a little bit of a hiccup. Today, a breeze.
21-12, 21-13.
21-12, 21-13, the scoreline. And Chao Chien-Tien, or Jano Jorgensen, we'll wait in the final. They'll be on in the match after next. But for now, job is done for Lin Dan.
Zweitplatzierter bei diesem Halbfinal heute gerade sich einen großen Applaus verdienen. Ihr Applaus für Son Wan Ho from Korea. Und wir freuen uns sehr über den Sieger und sagen erst einmal herzlichen Glückwunsch, Lin Dan.
Obviously, a word with the victor here.
Frau Zhao wird übersetzen und sie hat ihn auch in dieser Woche begleitet. Und unsere erste Frage ist, das sieht 21-12, 21-13 relativ deutlich aus. War das heute ein Lin Dan in Bestform?
Er findet sein Form ist von Tag zu Tag besser. Er ist heute schon im Finale. Er freut sich.
Das ist schon mal gut so, und er wird sich noch mehr freuen,
wenn er today and he's happy mit dabei to be in the final.
Sein großes Ziel sicherlich der dritte Olympiasieg. Ist das sein letzter großer sportlicher Traum?
Leave the court. Leave the court.
Just asking whether it's his dream to win three Olympic golds.
羽毛球里面男子单打能达到33岁的非常不容易，所以我先不去考虑今年的里约会怎么样。 希望今年先把上半年的比赛做好，也很感谢今天到场所有给我加油的中国的球迷，谢谢大家。
Es ist überhaupt nicht einfach, mit 33 in Herren Einzel zu behaupten hier. Er denkt jetzt noch nicht an Rio. Er möchte in die erste Hälfte Jahr gut spielen und er wünscht auch anderen chinesischen Spielern hier Glück.
Also sehr fair. Zum Abschluss eine Frage zu seinem Deutschland-Erfahrung. Er hat fünfmal dieses Turnier gewesen, war schon oft hier. Was verbindet er mit Deutschland?
He wants to wish the rest of the Chinese players here this week the best of luck.
为什么愿意到德国来比赛？因为每次来德国，我的成绩都非常理想。Jedes Mal, wenn er kommt, hat er einen schönen Eindruck.
12.
Na, dann haben wir den auf jeden Fall auch und freuen uns. Der erste im Finale. Ihr Applaus für Lin Dan.
I hope you got a gist of what Lin Dan was saying there. He's certainly got some of his fan club here, and getting better day by day. Certainly convincing today. So congratulations indeed to Lin Dan, who on our order play today joins Li Yongdei, Yu Yunxiong and Wang Xixian as winners in the semi-finals. And it's women's doubles next. Nitya Krishinda Maswari and Gracia Polly taking on Putita Subajirakun and Sapsari Tara Tanakai. And this is how they have got there. Stoeva sisters beaten by the number one seeds yesterday. Three games for required for Petita and Sapsari in their win against the world junior champions. Chen Qingchen and Jia Yifan they beat. So it's the Indonesians on the left, the Thai players on the right. There's Maswari and Polly. Maswari at the front, Gracia Polly just behind her.